Today, we're going to talk about the bimanual pelvic exam and rectovaginal exam. Maayong hapon, ma'am. Ako di ay si Shaira Tan. Ako ang masikaso ni mo karon. Ako di ang i-perform karon, ma'am, kay bimanual examination. So, mag-IE ko ni mo para ma-assess na ako ang imuhang external genitalia, imong vagina, cervix, uterus, ug adnexa. Mag-perform sad ko og rectovaginal exam, ma'am. Ako lang isulod akong usa ka tudlo sa inyong puwetan. Place the patient in a comfortable dorsal lithotomy with the buttocks at the edge of the examining table. Observe asepsis by putting gloves over examining hand. Inspect mons pubis, labia majora, labia minora, and perineal body for skin characteristics, hair distribution, contour, and swelling. Check the clitoris and note the size and shape. Observe the introitus and take note if the hymen is intact, imperforate or open, and whether the perineum gapes or remains closed in the lithotomy position. Inspect the perianal area for evidence of hemorrhoids, sphincter injury, warts, and other lesions. With the second and fourth fingers of the gloved hand separating the labia minora, the urethra is inspected and the length of the urethra is palpated and milked with the middle finger. The gloved hand then palpates the area of the posterior third of the labia majora, placing the index finger inside the introitus and the thumb on the outside of the labium. With the gloved hand holding the labia apart, the opening of the vagina should be inspected. Evaluate for pelvic organ prolapse. Put lubricant on index and middle fingers. Introduce well-lubricated index and middle fingers of the dominant hand into vagina, directing them posteriorly. The thumb should be pointing upward to minimize discomfort for the patient. Test the strength of perineum by pressing downward on perineum and asking patient to bear down. The opposite hand is then placed on the patient's abdomen. Press abdominal hand on the infra-umbilical area. Very gently press downward, sweeping the pelvic structures toward the palpating vaginal fingers. Elevate the uterus by pressing up on the cervix and delivering the uterus to the abdominal hand. Evaluate the uterus for position, architecture, size, shape, symmetry, tumor, consistency, tenderness, and mobility. Size may be estimated in centimeters or by comparing with weeks of normal gestational age. Evaluate the cervix for position, architecture, consistency, and tenderness, especially on mobility of cervix. Place vaginal fingers in the right lateral fornix. The abdominal hand is placed just medial to the ASIS on the right. The two hands are brought as close together as possible and with a sliding motion from the area of the ASIS to the introitus. The fingers are swept downward, allowing for the adnexa to palpate it in between them. Outline the adnexa and note for tenderness, masses, and mobility. Palpate the left adnexal region by repeating the technique above. Withdraw middle finger from the vagina and insert into anal canal while index finger remains in the vaginal canal. Evaluate the tone of external sphincter muscle, tenderness, tumor, irregularities, fixation or mobility in the rectovaginal septum and rectum. Remove and examine both fingers for evidence of gross blood, purulent material, and other alterations in color or consistency of vaginal discharge and stool. Properly annotate report of findings. Explain the findings to the patient and inform her what to expect after the procedure. Ask patient for any questions or clarifications.